It is a meditational pyramid. Okay, it is built in 30 acres. It started 5 years ago. Huge pyramid. 5,000 people can sit and meditate. Okay, and our founder Brahmarshi Patriji, his vision is to teach meditation to everyone. Okay, so whether they are corporate working, whether they are engineers, whether they are doctors, whether they are workers, housewives, or anything, everybody is a human being ultimately. We are all human beings with emotions. And maybe we learn skills. According to your skills, you are here, right? Right? Whatever the skills you have done, because of that you are here, right? But we get knowledge. How we get knowledge? Degrees. Somebody has done a BE, somebody has done an MBA, somebody has... Okay. You got the training. Somebody has gone to a company, got trained in soft skills. Oh, so many skills in software, hardware, soft skills, communication skills, writing skills. So, but this is about knowledge and skills. The next one is attitude. But the attitude is, nobody really cares for attitude. There is no school to teach an attitude. Okay? In the whole, all over the India, now they are showing interest in attitudes. The attitude has to be changed. What attitude? We all give up very fast. We talk negative. It is actually the influence of the TV and whatever we talk. So it's not positive. The people don't cooperate. These are all negative inputs we ask and talk. But when we convert that impossible to I am possible. So the same I am, if we just separate impossible to I am possible. So it's the attitude. Maybe if I show you a half glass water, half glass with a glass of full half water, a pessimist will say half is empty. It's a negative thinking. But an optimist will say that is half is full. How can I make it full? Half is there. So the way you look at life, the same glass of water, half. A pessimist will say, there is only half. Life is like this, half. But an optimist, yes, a positive man, at least half is there. How can I? So the attitude comes the next. And then comes, we eat food. Uta martivi. Why do we eat food? For body, nutrition, strength. We sleep for the body. Correct? We read, we go to a movie, mind, recreation. So we, it's all about mind. You use your mind here. Use your brain. And we'll never do anything for our soul. So meditation is the food for soul, which is not visible. Your mind also you cannot see, but you can see your body. But whatever happens to your mind, it is connected to your body. You just see the psychology. Just see the psychology. You walk in a, you know, very slowly with a depressive mood. Slowly you start get fever also. Okay? You start negative. You know, always that's not working. This is not working. You see, the psychology starts, if you are talking that, you know, if your psychology is weak, the physiology also will become, okay? The way you sit, the way you talk, the way you are enthusiastic. See, enthusiastic people, they get cured fast because they are positive. Yes, I'll get cured. Because even if you give medicine, what will happen? It will kill only the germs or whatever bacteria. But will it give you willpower? If a person who gets willpower, definitely get healed faster. So the meditation heals any kind of physical diseases. Mind becomes calm, cool, and is the biggest factor of enemy of our today's life is stress. S-T-R-E-S-S. Stress. It is not the anything. It is not money. It is the stress. Stress. You want to achieve a lot of things, you don't have clarity of goals, correct? I was talking to Varun ji, because most of the problem is even the God comes in front of you, what do you want? You don't know what you want. Tell me, how many people really can answer this question? He'll come in front of you, like in the movies. He say, what do you want? He'll start scratching your head. He'll say, I'll come back after 10 years. Okay? So you lose your 10 years. You have to have a clarity of goals, what you're doing, where you're working, what am I improving, where I should go, what I should do in my life. So all this is a long term. Even goal setting. We all set goals, but only in the mind. Goal should be in the script. Always youngsters, I always tell, if the goal is in the mind, it is an ineffective goal. If the goal is on a paper, or maybe on a printout, you can take a print. What do you want? Okay? You go to a shopping center with a list of, But if you don't have a list for your own life, what do you tell you? You go to a big bazaar with a list, what do you want? With brands, I want Parachute open wide only. I want close-up toothpaste. If it's not available, you don't buy. So, what do you want in life? Do you have a list for your own self? Most of the people don't have a list. Okay? Beautiful formula, we talk it as SMART formula. S-M-A-R-T. S stands for specific. M stands for measurable. Your goal should be measurable. How much? How much you want to increase your skill? How much? It should be action oriented. It should be reachable goal. It should be have a time bound. T. SMART. You don't have any of this. But we want to achieve a lot of things. How is SMART? It's not SMART. So, please write down or S-M-A-R-T. But even if you have S-M-A-R-T, it's not enough. Again, you are stressed because of your obsession with the goal. Because most of the companies are deadline-driven. No doubt, there's a deadline-driven. There's a certain kind of competence level you need to develop. Because you can't work like bullock car. Okay? Things are fast today. And you need to get into that fast life. And etched your mind should be calm. How is it? Only a calm mind can be effective, can be creative. You got it? Not otherwise. If your mind is disturbed, just a simple traffic jam can take away your whole day's peace. Okay? Just a traffic jam. No, traffic jam is there. Here comes the spirituality. Here comes the meditational value. Traffic jam is there. But why you are going cursing the government? Why you are going cursing the police? Why you are cursing the metro? Take it easy. Nobody has told you this, but I am telling you now, okay? Take it easy. Listen to FM. Okay? Or do something else. Call somebody. So, in life, whatever you want, you may not get. You may get more or less. Accept it. But we don't accept. We want the way we want. What happens? So, and also, when you're working among in a team, I always tell this story. Once a crippled man and a blind man come across a forest. They have to cross. It's already 4 o'clock. They don't know how to cross. One person was blind, another person was crippled, without legs. Okay? They are worried, how to cross, it's already late, nobody is there to take it. When another person comes, he solves the problem. You sit on his back, you show the road, he will carry you. The weakness of the crippled man is his legs, the strength is his eyes. Okay? The weakness of a blind man is eyes, and strength is so. In the team, there will be a lot of weaknesses. There will be. You need to adjust to that. Everybody would not be like mangoes. Everybody is a mango. Who is? Nobody will. It's like human beings are also like that. Your efficiency levels are different. Your background is different, your language is different, especially in a place like Bangalore, it's cosmopolitan. Like, from, you cannot discriminate Talab based on language, based on creed, based on color, background, accent. So we all do that. But somewhere the common thread is spirituality. When you know that there's a common, you tell me what is the color of your blood? Red. What is the color of the air you breathe? Any color? Any color? The way you breathe the same air, I breathe the same air. Where is Karnataka air? Where is any Andhra air? Any Punjab air is here? But we create it. Don't you think we create it? So please. So that is, maybe somebody has to come like me and stop here at least. You've been doing it, stop it. Now onwards, open up. Okay. See, there's a common, when there's a breath is common, why can't we look into the breath inside us? So what is meditation? Meditation is reducing your number of thoughts. You got it? So many thoughts. See, for example, I'm an engineer, I'm a builder.